The Fed had suggested that they were only temporarily helping out the markets through the repo operations in which most activities are within a given day. Of course, that changed rather quickly, and the Fed decided to launch QE4 with treasuries. In the words of Jerome Powell, this is not the large-scale asset purchases that were seen after the financial crisis. However, the Fed will exceed the peak of its balance sheet from a few years ago in just a few months if they keep up this pace. With the ECB following suit, it's very clear that central banks are trying to reflate the biggest bubble in the history of the world. You came here for the truth, so let me unveil that for you. Today we're talking about central banks. This is a recurring theme here at the Money GPS. Why? Because they are the most important factor for what we are seeing today in the stock market and in the economy. And it's not a good thing for the economy. However, their activities have clearly benefited the stock market. If you want to know whether stocks will go up or down, you need to look at the global money supply. This is the most important indicator. When I look at the statistics, when I look at the fundamentals, all of this is very critical. There's no doubt about it. But underlying all of that, it is central banks. They have remained integral to what has happened here. And unfortunately, for the average person, this robs from them on a daily basis. A lot of people believe that these activities are good, they're beneficial because they support the markets. However, in the end, it's actually going to make it worse. It's going to hurt a lot of people. There's no doubt about it. Now, today I want to look at what's happening with the Fed. I'm going to show you the balance sheet. I'm going to show you some charts that go along with that. I want to talk about the ECB as well. I've got a lot of documentation to get into. Let's begin right away. I told you it wasn't going to be long before the Federal Reserve had increased their balance sheet beyond $4 trillion, and here we are today. These numbers come as of October 31st. I'll bring you the updates as they come along, but this is the newest information that is available through the Federal Reserve, just above that $4 trillion mark. Now you can see, after a long period of time, the Federal Reserve slowly but surely getting rid of their assets. Assets that didn't fare very well with the markets, and now we can see the direction they are heading. It's only going to take a few months for them to exceed where they were before. We will watch the Federal Reserve expand their balance sheet to new record highs, and a lot of people are going to be pushing for this. The question is, how is this sustainable? A lot of people do believe that the Federal Reserve can print for infinity without consequences. I do believe that the Federal Reserve can simply run the printing presses and print up quadrillions of dollars in a day. We have seen that historically. Other central banks have tried to do the same. All of them have failed. Every single instance, empires of the past debased their coinage, and it always destroyed not just their currency, but their entire empire. There's no difference in between what we're seeing today and what we saw back during those times. From Athens and Greece and every single moment throughout history where there have been hundreds of these hyperinflations, why in the world would this time be different? It's an absolutely ridiculous notion. The question is, how long until that actually happens? Now, we may go through several cycles until that moment occurs. It might be decades, who knows? But there are going to be cycles in between now and then, and we will watch as the markets will rise and fall, the economies will do well and do poorly, and we are simply gonna be spectators. All I know is that what these central banks are doing are in the end hurting people. We had an entire time frame here, 10 years, where central banks have intervened on an unprecedented level globally that never stopped. It literally didn't stop the entire time throughout this quote-unquote recovery. And so here we are today, 2019, going into 2020, seeing this new cycle beginning. And really, it's a continuation of what we had seen for 10 years. I have no idea how far they are willing to take it in this cycle, but I am very excited to see what happens. Northman Trader said this, Fed balance sheet now north of $4 trillion again, increasing by over $261 billion in just 2 months. That's $1.566 trillion on an annualized basis. But remember, it's not QE because the Fed said so. This is completely accurate. And of course, it really helps to conclude what I was saying a moment ago. On Friday, total stock market capitalization to GDP hit 145.6%. At the beginning of the year is 122%. The long-term average is 83%. So when we look at it on this particular indicator, it is extremely overvalued going back into the dot-com levels. We have watched so many different indicators pile up that show us that we have taken this too far. But as long as the central banks are there, people don't have any fear. That's what's so crazy about today. All of these big investors, whether it's Warren Buffett or others at this level, never talk about the fact that the central bank is intervening on an unprecedented level. They simply suggest that there is a great future ahead. Why can't we acknowledge why the markets are like this? That with this central bank intervention, we've simply eliminated the fear of the investor. Before I move on to the other charts and articles that I need to get into, Northman Trader also brought this one up. Total non-farm private payroll employment. Over the last year, this has been going down further and further, peaking out towards the end of 2018 at approximately 2.1% or so. And today it's closer to 1.5%, essentially showing you where the employment is going. Real Investment Advice had this to say. They talked about what Jerome Powell said at his latest speech and then made some comments. Let's take a look. What was not expected was the following statement. I think we would need to see a really significant move up in inflation that's persistent before we even consider raising rates to address inflation concerns. If you're watching the question and answer section of that particular event, you would have seen this, and they break it down, and I do think they're accurate in their assessment here. The statement did not receive a lot of notoriety from the press, but this was the single most important statement from the Fed chair Jerome Powell so far. In fact, we cannot remember a time in the last 30 years when a Fed chairman has so clearly articulated such a strong desire for more inflation. Why do we say that? Let's dissect the bolded words in the quote for further clarification. Really significant. Powell is not only saying that they will allow a significant move up in inflation, but going one better by adding the word significant. Persistent. Unlike the prior few Fed chairmen who claim to be vigilant towards inflation, Powell is clearly telling us that he will not react to inflation that is not only well above. Powell is clearly telling us that he will not react to inflation that is not only well beyond a really significant leap from current levels, but a rate that lasts for a period of time. Even consider if inflation is not only a really significant increase from current levels and stays at such levels for a while, they will only consider raising rates to fight inflation. This is a big deal, and I do believe that this is what they will allow to happen. They are going to ramp up the printing presses, they're going to bring interest rates all the way to the ground, and the devaluation of currencies will persist. Before I get into the ECB part of this video, the reason I mention that is simply that central bank policies, while they have been going on for a very long time, are accelerating, and none of them have actually fixed any of the problems that we have today. We have allowed these central banks to go out and buy up just about everything. They've reduced interest rates all the way. They've done so many different activities, and yet, if you look at it on all of these different measures, the amount of debt, the national debt, the deficits, so on, everything looks worse. So doing more of the same isn't going to fix the problem. Okay, so this is just to begin what I wanted to get into. Endless money printing programs will cause tremendous and damaging changes to stock markets. Wall Street has warned new ECB president Christine Lagarde. The ECB restarted their QE this week to tackle the region's slowdown, but analysts at Bank of America America predicted the bond buying program will mean debt, not stocks, the financing tool of the future. The cost of taking on debt for firms will be pinned down by QE, a key tool used by central banks to boost economies following the financial crisis. I think we're in a world of hurt right now, and the central banks are going to go out there. They're going to continue to buy the corporate debt like the ECB has been doing. They're going to do what the Bank of Japan has been doing. All of them are going to institute a policy that is essentially helping out their friends. And I do believe it may be implemented in a different way that we saw back in 2008. Restarting the controversial policy of QE has caused a rift at the ECB's highest ranks, with one German policymaker quitting the board in protest. Many Northern European governments say that the policies punish savers and keep zombie business alive. This is a big problem that they don't want to talk about, of course, and suggest they're working on it, don't worry about it, not a problem, nothing to see here, and so on. What seems a given is that credit markets will experience another bout of rapid expansion, coaxed on by the proliferation of negative yields. And of course, we know how big this has become already. Imagine where it's going to be in a year from now. This article here is talking about Greece's former finance minister. I might butcher his name, but Varoufakis. He made a lot of headlines during the Greek crisis, and he's still going on today. There are a couple points I wanted to mention. The ECB needs to reinvent itself and come up with new policy tools, as its bond buying program is no longer effective. And we've watched this previously. They were printing a lot of money every single month. Now they intend on printing 20 billion euro per month. And if the previous instances didn't work, why would even less of that have any effect? It's crazy, but that's what we're looking at. This is just an excuse to get their feet in and start to play around before they ramp it up. And the quote towards the bottom here, QE, the way it has been restructured, resembles an antibiotic that has stopped working because the bacteria have grown to adapt to it. Now, this to me is very good, an excellent analogy, and there's no other way to put it. Okay, that's enough. I'm gonna finish the video there. If you found it informative, hit that like button. When you hit the thumbs up button, you are supporting this channel, so I do appreciate that very much. If you wanna learn how to actually make money online, then this is for you. It's a step-by-step guide for Amazon. I teach everything in here, and it's 100% free. The course I took is now $1,000. I'm now on my second course, going through the entire thing. Still learning today, even though I already fully understand the process. Why? Because the knowledge never stops. If you want to get your feet wet, if you want to learn about this business, the Amazon GPS is definitely for you. That's available at theamazongps.com. If you have any interest in learning about the financial system, that one that was completely hidden from you during your entire education, then check out these two books. Links are in the description. If you want the audiobook, that's at themoneygps.com. This is a really important video, and I hope that if you haven't watched it, you're gonna click on there, and I'll see you soon.